All even knew I do for a decent house and a plate of food. Better pay, don't make the news.
That's right, that's right.
Look,
pack going up. Golly Goku, what you know about that? Golly side Goku and that. Come on, drip low Goku, what you know about that one? Yes, yes, yes. It's that G-Tile D and I'm back on the screen with another one, man. Now, today, I'm bringing you guys some tips, you know, some tips on how to best manage your waves to make sure that you are making the most amount of progress possible, okay? We're trying to be effective and efficient, you know what I'm saying? So make sure you like this video because I know it's going to help you out. These five tips are really going to help you out. Make sure you subscribe as well. We're going for 200 subscribers, so click that button and make sure you click the bell so you get notified next time I drop a video, man. Today, I'm going to bring you the five things that you should do to supercharge your wave progress, and in the next video I'm gonna tell you guys the don'ts, man, so make sure you click that subscribe button and click that bell. So let's get straight into this. I'm gonna start off with the most obvious, all right? The most obvious: wear your do-rag at all times, okay? Wear your do-rag at all times. If you are not brushing, you should be wearing your do-rag. That is the rule that you should be following. Calm. Nice and easy. Follow that rule. Trust me, you'll see some amazing progress, man. If you guys want to know about the different types of do-rags, I've got a video for that. And if you guys want to know about how to tie your do-rag, I've got a video for that. Card in the top right. Go check them out, man. Rule number two, brush with a mirror. Especially if you're a beginner.
Now listen, that's called motherfucking bars.
Brush with a mirror, man. Because the mirror is going to help you to see where you're brushing, make sure you're consistent with your angles at all times, and it's going to help you to identify areas of improvement. Forks, for example, you're going to be able to brush those out. It's going to enable you to get better connections. Trust me, brushing with the mirror is going to help you. I can't tell you how much progress I made in my waves when I was when I started brushing with a mirror. It changes everything, man. So make sure you go do that. Brush with a mirror. Step number three, use your brushes correctly, okay? And when I say this, you need to understand one, the different types of brush, and two, what each of those different types is used for, and make sure you are using them correctly, okay? Because if you don't, you're gonna mess up. You're not gonna be making as much progress as you should be doing, and your waves aren't gonna look as good as they could be looking. All right, so make sure you are using your brushes correctly. If you wanna know what all the different types of brushes are and when to use them, video in the top right, go check it out, man. But you wanna make sure that you're using your hard brushes to get that progress, or your hard or your medium, depending on your hair type, to get that progress, and make sure you're using that soft brush to lay it all down, all right? If you guys wanna buy some brushes, man, chamair.com. TileD20 for 20% off. Go check them out, particularly if you're based in the UK. That's the plug right there, man. Trust me. So, number four. Now, this is a really important one, especially if you have low porosity hair, okay? If you have low porosity hair, you absolutely have to do this. And I know most of you aren't doing this, all right? Apply heat to your hair before putting any kind of moisturizing products, any of that stuff. Apply heat to your hair, okay? Do it, because the heat is gonna open up your pores. If you have low porosity hair, you're gonna need that help to open up your pores, man, because, I mean, your hair is low porosity, not very porous, doesn't accept moisture in as easily as high porosity hair. This is still good for high porosity hair, trust me, but it's essential for low porosity hair. Apply heat to your hair before and even during, if you can, when you're putting products in your hair, because that's gonna help your hair to absorb that moisture much, much, much more effectively. I cannot stress this enough. If you don't do that, you're gonna end up having an itchy head and scalp. Your hair is gonna look dry because it's just gonna have product buildup all sitting on your hair. It's gonna be, you just don't want that, man. You don't want that. So apply heat. If you guys wanna know how I moisturize my hair and how I apply heat to my hair when I want to do that, card in the top right, man, I got a video for that. Come on, man, I got it all, come on. And then the last step, step number five, wash your brushes. I know you ain't washing your brushes. What if I asked you the last time you washed your brush, you're gonna tell me,
you ain't never washed your brush before.
Or, I don't know,
like a year ago.
Or,
I just buy a new brush every time I wanna.
Just stop that, stop it. Wash your brush, man, okay? The reason why you wanna wash your brush because if you're not washing your brush is gonna have dirt in it, dust in it, grime, grease, all that stuff. And you're brushing your hair with that. And then you wonder why your hair looks dirty, why it looks dry, why it looks like it's all like product and stiffy and all that stuff. Because all of that crap in your brush is coming into your hair. That's why a lot of people overwash their hair and apply too much product in their hair, because they're looking at their hair, they're thinking,
ah, my hair doesn't look that shiny, it ain't really got that shine, you know? It looks kind of dead, kind of dry, and that it looks kind of dirty, I should probably wash it.
It's because you're using a dirty ass brush. It don't make no sense. If you go have a shower, then roll in mud, that don't make no sense. You're gonna look at yourself like you're stupid. That's what you're doing when you use a dirty brush in your hair. It's like cleaning your hair and then just rolling in mud. It's dumb. So stop doing that. Wash your brushes, man. And if you guys don't know how to do that, I got a video for you, man. Card in the top right, go check it out. Come on now. I got you guys. I got you guys on everything, man. But yeah, man, that's it for this video. I gave you guys 5 things to do. We're gonna recap them right now. Number one, if you are not brushing, you should be wearing your do-rag, all right, at all times. Number two, brush with a mirror. Brush with a mirror so you can see what you're doing, consistent angles, and you'll get better connections that way. Number three, use your brushes correctly. Use them correctly so you're making the most amount of progress and your waves look the best they can look, okay? Number four, use heat before you moisturize, especially if you have low porosity hair, man, so you can get those products into your hair and your scalp. And rule number five, wash your damn brushes, man, okay? So I know this video helped you out, so make sure you smash the like button, right? Do it right now, it's over there at the bottom of the screen underneath the video. Just smash the like button, do it. It takes like 2 seconds and it helps me out so I can help you out. So help me out so I can help you out and smash the like button, okay? And then hit the subscribe button, you know what I'm saying? The big red one, hit it. And hit the bell right next to it so you get notified next time I drop a video, man. In the next video, I'm gonna be telling you guys all about the 5 things that are killing your progress and that you should stop doing right now. And I mean, if you guys need a video to watch, I have a whole playlist on how to go from no waves to a head full of waves, man. So make sure you go check that out, all right? It's been at G Tower D. Wave to the world, and I'm out.